What's the most important thing that a contractor needs to know? A contractor needs to be able to track expenses and profit by job. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. QuickBooks Online can track expenses and profits by job. QuickBooks Online calls this feature tracking expenses by customer. We activated this feature in the prior video regarding changing account settings. Each expense, bill, and check that you record will have a field to put in the job or customer that it relates to. You can then check the results in the report called Profit and Loss by Customer. Let's add vendors to the vendor list and add Transaction List by Vendor to the Custom Reports tab. We click the Reports tab in the left panel, then go back to the standard list of reports and scroll down very slowly until you get to the section of Vendors and Expenses. Now, here in the Expense and Vendor section, we have Transaction List by Vendor. Click on it, then go to the pull-down date menu, choose All Dates, click Run Report, now click Save Customization, and then again click Save. Now when we click Reports and go over to the Custom Reports tab, we see that we now have added Transaction List by Vendor to our list of reports that we go directly to navigate QuickBooks Online. Now, let's add this list of vendors, and we'll read them off one by one. You will find that adding vendors to the vendor list is exactly the same as adding customers to the customer list. If you remember, for customers, we clicked Sales and went to Customers, and then we click New Customer. So it's the same thing. We click Expenses and Vendors, and because this is the very first time that we're coming to this window, we're going to click Add Vendor Manually. Now, well, I'm going to click Don't Allow, don't worry about that, but notice the Add Vendor window is the same. And I think the first one is Rex Repair Shop, capital letters. Now, of course, in a real situation, we would add the other information like address and phone number and so on. But right now, we're just trying to set up our QuickBooks for the course. So we're just going to click Save for the first one. Now, if you have visited this window before, this is what the window will look like when you first come here, obviously minus what we just added. So to add new vendors from now on, we click New Vendor, come back to this very same window, Lana the Lawyer. And of course, click Save. Now we have two vendors on the list. Who's next? UPS and FedEx, respectively. New Vendor. Save, New Vendor, Save. Who's next? We're almost done. Bill the Independent Builder. I should have put Bob the Independent Builder, but we'll go with Bill. Save. Almost finished with this part. Staples, office supplies, and Home Depot. New vendor. And the last one will be Home Depot. Okay, save. Now if you look at the vendor list, it looks very, very similar to the customer list. And you can always come here and you can always edit any vendor by clicking on their name in the list. And then once their information is in front of you, click edit, and you can change any of the permanent long-term information about your vendors. Now let's do an example. Let's imagine on February 25th, we paid $300 for a delivery needed on the Kirschbaum Southwoods Road job, and we paid this with transfer number 12345, and we will use the expense window to record this. So we click expenses and expenses, and of course, because this is the very first time that we are coming to this window, we get this little message. So you would click add expenses manually, and then you would come here. You might get a couple of other pop-ups if it's the first time coming to this window. So click past them so that you can get to the expense window. Now we know that we paid UPS. And we know that we paid on February 25th, so you have to change the date to whatever you need to make it February 25th. Now we can skip payment method if you paid online, but you should put the transaction number that the bank gave you when you transferred the money to UPS. And of course, the money amount is down here as $300. Now clearly, if we're paying UPS, the expense category is delivery expense. But the most important thing to notice in this window is the customer field. You have to click the pull down and choose the Kirschbaum Southwoods Road job in order to make sure that QuickBooks Online knows that this is specifically an expense for that job. Now when you click save and close, you can check the results in your profit and loss by customer. Click reports and go down to profit and loss. Oh, make sure you're in the custom tab and go down to profit and loss by customer. Now you can see if you scroll all the way to the right, okay, this is the Southwoods Road Kirschbaum job. We have $1,125 in income for invoices that we made for that job in prior videos. And that income is this category, income from heating repair. But if you go down a little more, you can see that we also had to pay $300 in delivery expense that relates to the Kirschbaum job in order to earn that $1,125. So right now, the net income or the net profit from the Southwoods Road building job is only $825. To understand this better, let's do a second example. Let's imagine on February 28, we gave check number 28 to Lana the lawyer for legal work done on the Southwoods Road job for Kirschbaum. And the amount of that check was $200. So, recording a check in QuickBooks Online is almost exactly the same as recording an expense the way we did a moment ago. We click New, go to the column of Vendors, and come down to Check. Now, the person whom we paid was Lana the lawyer. And the date that we paid her was February 28, and the check number that we physically handed to her had number 28 on it. Now, obviously, if we're paying a lawyer, the expense that we're paying in our chart of accounts would be legal and professional services, and the amount of that check was $200. The last thing we have to put is the specific job or customer that this expense relates to. So we click the pull down and we choose the Kirschbaum Southwoods Road job. When we click save and close, we come back to reports, custom, profit and loss by customer, and then we have to scroll over to the Kirschbaum job. Now take a look. We have income from heating repair for the Southwoods Road building job, $1,125. But in order to earn that $1,125 for that job, we had to pay $300 of delivery for that job and $200 of legal and professional services for that job. So if the total expenses for that job were $500, that means right now we're only running a profit of $625 for that job. In closing, we should really check the trial balance to see that any expense you record, regardless of which job it applies to, is an expense for the entire company. Watch reports and go down to trial balance, and you can see that the company now has delivery expense of $300 and legal and professional expense of $200. And if we use these expenses for other jobs, the previous report would separate them by job, but the trial balance would lump them together as the total amount of expenses. You will also notice that cash in bank has decreased for both of the expenses we just paid. And if you double-click the balance of cash in bank and scroll down, you can see that these were payments that we received from jobs, but here's the February 25th expense, and if we scroll to the right, you can see it lowered the balance by $300. Come to the left, you can see the check that we recorded on February 28th to Lana further lowered the balance by $200, and that's why the company is left with $3,500 in the bank account.